And now, Gangbusters, presented in cooperation with police and federal law enforcement departments throughout the United States, the only national program with authentic police case histories.
Presents the case of the Mound City safecracker, who found that a flask of liquor was more risky to handle than a vial of nitroglycerin.
Gangbusters has asked Detective Lieutenant John Sinclair, Police Department, St. Louis, Missouri, to narrate by proxy tonight's case. Lieutenant Sinclair, you told me tonight's case began in a cheap hotel on Market Street near the Union Station in St. Louis, Missouri, about 2 years ago.
That's right, Don Gardner. Room 18 had been occupied for the last few days by one James Moore, notorious Boston safecracker. But Moore was no longer trusted by his associates in the East. The reason was quite evident from a glance at the empty bottles in his room. Moore was spread across the bed, fully clothed, sleeping it off. As the noonday sun flashed in under the flapping black shade, the door to his room opened, but Mr. Moore didn't move.
Okay, there he is. Come on. Okay, Moore, on your feet. Come on, I said on your feet.
Straight right.
Get up, I said.
And any of your sludge from the bottom of the Charles River bartender, you get it right back in the eye.
Snap out of it, will you? I haven't got all day.
There's my drink.
I'll give you a drink. Here's a drink for you.
Thank you. Water.
Sure, it's water. You want more of it?
Oh, now I know you. You're a tin badge of a St. Louis copper.
Keep those hands yourself now.
I'll take more than one of you prairie pups from a policeman to haul Jim Moore in today.
Come on, you grab his other arm.
Huh? Oh, no. Not by no fluttering female policeman will I be taken through the streets like a cow being led by a milkmaid. Not by no female policeman.
Grab him, baby. Come on.
Hold it a minute, Robbie. Come with us, Moore. There's a bottle outside the car with this much in it.
A lure. A lure into the trap of doom.
We're not cops. Can't you get it through your head?
Huh?
No.
How much you say was in that bottle?
This much.
And home, we got it by the case.
How's the weather out? Do I need my rubbers?
The weather's fine.
To what fortunate turn of nature do I owe this generosity, my boy? And, my girl?
I figured you'd like to do a little teaching.
Teaching? If I'm to teach, who's the student?
Me.
Huh?
I want to learn all about drills. And punches. And knobs and nitroglycerin.
Mm-hmm. By the case, huh?
But one bottle at a time.
Yeah, well, one bottle at a time is enough for one man at a time. Well, what are we waiting
Watch
for?
Watch it!
Hey, easy, boy.
My underpinning needs a little shoring.
Just hold on to us. We'll get you there.
That's right. Now you just slip your arm around me there, sweetheart. We'll all go out together.
Peg? I give up. He's a rummy. Let's face it, it's no use.
I taught you plenty in 2 weeks, Robbie. So it'll take a little longer than you figured.
Will you stop that sewing machine? Him with the bottle, you with your sewing. You both drive me nuts. If you need a dress so bad, why don't you go out and buy one?
I'm hard to fit in the shoulders.
Why I ever had this crazy idea, I don't know. I'm going back to being a gunman. You walk in, you put a heater on him, you get their dough. That's all there is to it. You don't have to be a mechanic.
Do what you like, Robbie. I still think it's a good idea.
Would you shut that thing off before I throw it out the window?
Oh.
Every time I look at him, I hate him more.
Why? What's he done to you?
I don't know. Maybe I'm looking at myself 30 years from now.
Why don't you try taking the bottle away from him? When he gives, you give.
That don't work either. He may be the best safecracker ever to come out of Boston, but he sure needs a lot of lubrication. All morning, he's been trying to explain to me about keeping nitroglycerin at body temperature. I should keep it under my belt next to the skin. Yeah. I'll try it the way he says. Somebody will have to come pick me off the roof with a shovel.
Robbie.
What?
You think these buttons would be nice on here, or covered ones?
Oh, who cares?
What happens after you finish learning everything he knows?
He'll go along on a job with me. One job.
That won't make him happy.
Who wants to make him happy? They're gonna catch the old rumhead. Right in the act.
Hey. Isn't that kind of dangerous for you?
It's the safest way I can think of. We go over to some small town across the river. We break into a store. I work with them till almost time to set her off, and then I go out after the car. Boom. The cops are there. First thing you know, Moore's in Joliet or someplace where he won't give me any more trouble.
Oh, now, that's not right, and it's not fair.
Who cares what's fair? He's off our hands. Let me get back to the professor. I'll talk to you about it later. That's got it, Peg, right here.
Okay.
Leave the lights on. Moore.
Yeah?
Take the stuff and start to jimmy the back door. I'll be there in 2 minutes.
But, Robbie...
Go on, take the stuff.
Don't forget the bottle, Robbie.
Get out of here. Start on that door.
Hurry along, Robbie.
Just get that door jimmy, you hear? All right, Peg. Now you drive to the tavern and wait there. 11:45 on the dot, phone the sheriff's office. Tell them you were passing by and thought you saw somebody inside the clothing store.
Robbie, you're looking for trouble.
Stop worrying. I ought to be at the tavern by the time you get off the phone.
Suppose your watch stops. Suppose Moore doesn't do
it. Well, do it the way I said. Get rid of that bottle, baby. This is the best way I can think of.
When they pick him up, he'll talk.
So they'll be looking for me in Illinois. They're looking for me anyway.
Okay, Robbie.
Look, pack me in, kid. When we hit Chicago, I line up the best crew of safe crackers ever worked the Midwest. Go on.
Wonderful.
What's the sheriff's office say?
They're sending somebody to investigate.
Perfect. Well, what are you drinking?
Now, come on, Robbie, let's get out of here.
What's your hurry?
I just don't like sticking around, that's all.
I thought it'd be kind of fun to keep our distance and watch them haul out old Lush in. Oh, this will cure them. You won't get a drink for 6 years at least.
Robbie, please, come on, let's go.
All right, baby. Not a bad idea, then. With a good start, we ought to make Chicago before daybreak.
So, Don, Robert Lee Robertson, the St. Louis bandit turned safecracker, headed for Chicago to organize a gang of burglars who were to lead Midwest authorities, both federal and local, on a wild chase. Until a vial of nitroglycerin blew the gang's hopes sky high.
You were telling us, Lieutenant Sinclair, how Robert Lee Robertson turned from banditry to safe-cracking, employing the technique of an old-time burglar whom he used as a tutor.
That's right, Don. And within a few weeks, the gang was striking so often and so swiftly that law enforcement officers from each of four states met in Chicago one day with agents of the Federal Bureau of Investigation and post office inspectors. As the meeting progressed, Captain George Mantell, safe and loft expert of the Chicago Police Department, was called on for his opinion.
And as it stands, gentlemen, these criminals are running from one jurisdiction to another, hitting small towns, avoiding big cities like Chicago and St. Louis.
Captain Mantell.
Yes?
Is it your opinion that Robertson is working small towns, then running back to Chicago, for instance, to lay out until his next job?
Yes, I was going to ask that.
Yes, I'd say that's probably what they're doing.
Uh-huh.
Now, Special Agent Wright of the FBI has a suggestion. I think it might help us as much as anything. Mr. Wright.
Well, gentlemen, what'll help us most is information. Any scrap that's picked up by members of any of your departments should be forwarded here to Chicago, either to me or to Captain Mantell.
Good idea. I'd
rather imagine we'll sift every bit of information we get. We'll piece it together with what we already have. Maybe with a little teamwork among all of us, we'll be able to locate these men and get enough evidence to convict them.
Oh, Peg, come in.
Everything okay?
Couldn't be better.
Robbie.
Is it okay?
Yeah, okay, come on.
All right, Peg, get inside.
Hey, Robbie.
Well, where's Cargo?
Yeah.
She got the new guy?
Yep.
Hey, where's that sewing I left here last night?
How should I know?
How does he look to you, Miller?
Left it right there on the table.
Will you stop worrying about your pins and needles?
I've been working a month on that blouse.
I didn't touch it.
Well, somebody
did. Okay, who cares?
Don't leave anything around you guys.
Miller.
Yeah?
What do you think of this new guy?
Well, Cargill says he knows his stuff.
I can find that out from Cargill. What do you think of
him? He looks okay to me. Good man with the soup, they say.
Cargill, come in here. I want to talk to you.
Robbie.
Yeah, what?
Now that we're back in Chicago, can't we stay here a couple of days?
No.
When are you going to spend all this money?
When I retire.
When you retire. What the devil happened to that sewing?
Hello, Robbie.
Cargill.
Come on, meet this guy, Robbie. He knows his business.
Cargill, did you see my sewing?
Will you shut up?
Oh, for...
Where's he from?
The East.
Where in the East?
I don't know. Did he tell you, Miller?
Or should he tell me?
What kind of a deal is this? You bring me a knob knocker, you don't know where he's from.
He's okay. I'm telling you, he's okay.
We'll see. Miller.
Yeah, Robbie?
When I'm talking to this guy, take the car out back. Put those new Nebraska plates on it.
Right, boys.
Come on, Robbie. I'll introduce you to this guy.
I can introduce myself.
Okay.
Hi, I'm the... Peg. Peg.
What, Robbie?
Come in here.
What is it? I'm looking for my... Hello, Moore.
So you're the big soup man from the East.
You should have come back for me that night, Robbie, my boy. The safe was loaded with currency of every denomination and 2 quarts of Kentucky bourbon bottled in bond.
Well, if you'll excuse me...
Peg, come here.
What is it, Robbie?
You knew this whiskey head was here.
No, I didn't.
You know, he was the old fish that were going to spring on me.
Have a drink, Robbie. Have yourself.
I'll give you a drink.
Robbie! Oh.
Get out of here, Peg. Go on, get out.
Robbie,
go on, get out.
All right.
Wait for me out there.
She's a sweet one, Robbie. Sweet like the morning dew before the mountain sun comes up.
Okay, never mind the poetry. One thing I want to find out from you and then walk out of here and forget you ever seen a place. I don't want no rum pots under my nose.
I'm afraid you're stuck with me, Robbie.
Now, listen here.
Hands off. Ah. Here's one bottle you won't be so quick to knock on the floor. Nitroglycerin. My nitroglycerin.
Put that soup on the table, Moore, and walk out of here.
You're not feeding me whiskey an ounce at a time now, Robbie. I'm doing the feeding, and I'm giving the orders. From now on, I'm a full partner in your noble aggregation.
That's what you say.
You'll say it too, Robbie. You'll say it with words of welcome, or the bottle smashes on the floor like you smashed that bottle of good red whiskey.
Is that so?
I swear it by all the oaths my father taught me. I'm in, huh, Robbie? I'm in or I blow us both to the house to who knows where.
You're not in.
I've lived a long time, Robbie, and I've waited a long time for right now. Say yes or hold onto your hat.
Get out of here, Moore.
The orders are coming from me. Jim Moore, master of his trade. Say yes. Say you're in, Moore. Say it.
You haven't got the nerve. Go on, blow us up. Well, what are you waiting for? Go on.
Oh, you win, Robbie. I couldn't smash the bottle, not even for a place in heaven insured.
Give me that soup, you.
Give it. Yeah. Now, Robbie, don't.
All right, sit down there. Go on, sit down.
Robbie, don't.
Shut up. Thanks for handing me the little idea about another use for the nitro. I'll remember it if I ever get on a spot. Only you and me are different, Moore. When I have to, I'll smash the bottle.
Pity a poor soul who was once king of all,
I'll
Robbie.
Pity you, all right. I'll put you out of your misery.
Oh, Robbie. Robbie, no!
Cargo, Miller.
Miller went out to the car.
Go in there and watch that guy. Don't let him out of your sight.
Ain't he all right?
Get in there and watch him, will
you? Okay, don't get excited.
Peg, I ought to pin your ears back for this.
For what?
You didn't call the cops that night.
I did, Robbie. I did exactly what you told me.
Don't lie to me.
Let go.
What do you think I'm running around here? What do you think I'm running, an old folks home?
Hey, Robbie, stop it.
You didn't call the cops, did you? Did you?
I couldn't. Not on the old guy. I couldn't.
When I tell you to do something, you'll do it.
All right, Robbie. All right. From now on, anything you see.
You bet your life you'd do anything I say.
Anything.
Hey.
Well, Robbie. New Nebraska plates are on a car.
Okay. We'll leave in 20 minutes.
What about the new guy? We're taking him along on a job?
We're taking him along, but not on a job. He gets dumped about halfway.
Robbie!
What's the matter? He seemed okay to me.
Well, you don't count.
You're not going to kill him.
You want to go along?
What do you think you are, Capone or somebody? Just a small-time hoodlum that's had a little luck.
That's enough.
Just a little luck, that's all.
One more peep out of you and you'll be the same ditch as Moore, you hear? Now find your son and sit down in that chair and do it. Don't go out, don't call nobody, don't do nothing. You just sit there and sew. When I get back, we'll settle this thing between you and me once and for all.
FBI, Special Agent Wright.
This is Captain Mantell. We just got our hands on a bit of information about Robertson.
Oh, anything good, Captain?
Well, I can't say. But Robertson's supposed to have just gotten a set of Nebraska license plates.
Yes?
The last three numbers are 061. I put it out on the teletype, and all radio points will pick it up for broadcast. Maybe this is the break that we've been waiting for.
Look, Robbie, I don't want to get mixed up in no killing. I got nothing against the guy.
Yeah, Robbie, just tell me why. If you tell me why, then it might be okay.
It's okay because I say so. Drive, Cargo. Let's all just drive. And you, Miller, keep your mouth shut.
Let me kill the bottle before you give me the push, Robbie.
Shut up.
If you think I'm scared, you're thinking right. Gee, I wish I had more of a load on. If I had more of a load on it, it'd be like dropping off into a feather bed.
Shut up, will you? There's a spot up ahead, Cargo.
Look, Robbie,
okay, that's enough. It'd be just like you, Moore, to come back and haunt me.
You could count on it, Robbie.
All right, where'd you rather have it? In the head or in the belly?
Let me go, Robbie.
I'm doing you a favor, Rum-Dum. Make up your mind, where?
Robbie, it's cops.
Hey, get moving. Get moving, Cargo.
Don't worry. State Highway Patrol, Robbie.
They must have made the license plate. Go on faster. I guess you get a reprieve, Moore.
Oh, for once in my life, I wish the cops well.
Go on.
It's down to the floor. We're pulling away from him.
Cargo.
Yeah?
Douse the lights.
Hey.
There's a side road over the hill. Duck into it.
We can't run on a side road.
Maybe we'll lose them. If not, it's okay. There's enough of us. We'll fight it out and double back Chicago.
What about him?
He stays with us. For the time being. Go on, hit it, Cargill, hit it.
Hello, Captain.
Oh, right. You heard that the state police jumped up Robertson and his crew.
Yeah, too bad they lost them.
At least we were close. Oh, excuse me. Yeah. Captain Mantell. Oh. Was that so? What's the number again? Yeah, I've got it. Okay, we'll be right out there. Patrolman located the car, parked in front of an apartment building on the south side. The motor was still warm.
Well, let's go, Captain.
We'll just stop down at the desk, right, and put in a call for the riot squad. We may need them.
You got us in some mess, Robbie. Moore didn't do nothing to nobody.
Okay, so he didn't do nothing to nobody.
Now we're stuck with him here. We can't turn him out. We can't hold him. What are we going
to
do?
I'll figure that out after you get rid of the license plates in the car. I told you to take it around back an hour ago.
Miller said he'd attend to
it. I told you!
Now the car sets out there an hour, nothing's done about it. Peg.
Yeah?
Will you light someplace?
Okay, Rob.
Miller.
Keep your voice down, will you, Robbie? It's 4 a.m. The neighbors will have the cops down on us.
Miller.
Yeah, Robbie, what is it?
Bring more in here. I want to talk to you all.
Right.
Well, come on, Peg. Don't stand there.
I don't see what you're so hot under the collar about. If anybody's mad, it should be Moore.
You want some of the same treatment you got before?
Honest, Robbie, this whole business is going to your head. We were better off when...
Shut up, will you?
Okay.
All right, old time inside.
Well, Robbie, got yourself in a spot, haven't you? You're stuck with me like a tiger stuck with stripes.
I won't be stuck with you for long.
Hey.
Robbie.
Peg, ask who it is.
Who is it?
Police officers. Open up.
We're cooked.
Open up in there.
Get the machine gun. No, no, wait. Wait a minute. I got a better idea. Listen here, copper. I got nitroglycerin here, see? I'll blow you and us and everybody in this building straight to Milwaukee.
Robbie, put away that soup.
Put away, I'm going to use it. You hear that, copper? You hear that? I'm going to use it.
Open the door or we'll shoot through it.
Robbie, put that soup away.
Shoot through the door and you'll hit the soup, copper. You want to live, don't you, copper? You want to live? Let me get away or I'll blow you all to pieces.
Robbie, get some sense, will you? They got us.
Robbie, don't do it.
Jump him, Cargo.
Hurry!
Hey, let go of his arm.
Give me that.
Hold on to him.
Robbie!
On your feet. All of you, on your feet.
All right.
Take it easy, will you? Take it easy.
Give me that.
You want to use this stuff. I know him.
Go on. Line up against the wall there.
Okay, go on. I'm sure.
You too, Grandpa. Come on.
I'm as innocent as a new hatched chick.
We'll see how innocent you all are. All right, face the wall. Put your hands up high, all of you. Go on. That's it. Fine-looking bunch. Hey, Captain? Yeah. They look a lot finer through bars. Okay, men. Start shaking them down.
Take it easy. Yeah,
well, in this car.
That, Don, was the end of a notorious gang of safe burglars. They are all now serving long terms in various federal penitentiaries and still face trial on at least 150 charges of burglary in 5 states.
Well, thank you, Lieutenant Sinclair, for this extraordinary case history. And congratulations to the hundreds of police officers, federal and state, who participated in the investigation leading to the arrests and convictions. Tonight's case was dramatized by Stanley Niss and directed by William Sweets, with Ralph Bell and Walter Vaughn in leading roles. Don Gardner speaking. Gangbusters is a Phillips H. Lord production.